After you've unpacked your tote, you will find the following material. One large plastic bag, one waste label to be placed on the outside of the tote before pickup. Out of the two pieces of absorbent material, take one and you line the bottom of the container like so. You take your bag, open it up, place it inside, expand the bag. Further expand the bag and it should look something like that when it's done. This is very important. Included in the collection kit is a hazardous waste label. This is to inform other residents, family members, trashmen that the material in this container is not for them. All you do is remove the adhesive and you can place it right here on the front of the tote. On the day that your collection is scheduled, you'll be notified a few days in advance. You can put your tote out at any time that day. You do not have to be home. If by chance you don't get to put the tote out, we will still stop at your house. And if you're not there and we don't see the tote, we will leave a door hanger noting the reasons why we weren't able to pick up your waste, and we can reschedule you for another pickup. There's also a contact number of Stephen Clark, who's the Project HHW manager. You can contact him directly or you can contact me directly at 215-510-2373. Acceptable items: fertilizer, weed killer, pesticides, liquids and solids, aerosol cans, spray paints, oven cleaners, oil-based paints, concrete, driveway cleaner and or sealer, glues, the nickel cadmium batteries, lithium ion batteries from cameras, they're acceptable. Lead acid batteries are also acceptable, car size and down. Oils, antifreezes, different types of solvents, mineral spirits, toluene, acetone. And you may wonder, how could I possibly fit a light bulb in such a small container? Well, you can't. What you could do is wrap the light bulb in newspaper, tape it up gently, and place it alongside the collection kit before you're notified of your pickup date. Items that are not acceptable: construction debris, residential trash, vacuums, any electronic waste, treated lumber with creosote. This isn't a railroad tie, but it represents one. They're not acceptable. Smoke detectors are not acceptable. Medical waste and red bags are not acceptable. Needles are not acceptable. TVs are not acceptable. Vacuum cleaners. Bear in mind, this should be done in a location where it's not going to be too far from the porch where you're going to eventually leave it. So what you do is you would take your material like such. You have some stain blocker. You have some driveway cleaner. We have some adhesive caulk. You have starting fluid, and so on and so forth. Take the bag together. Don't fill it past the point where the lid won't close. And with the provided twist tie, cinch it up. Put it down like so. Place the locking lid on it firmly. Lock it so each side snaps.